anything that's a challenge, you know, I want to take on the challenges that are available. So golf is definitely a sport that is not going to be easy at your first time, or, you know, no matter how many times you play, it never gets easy. It would be difficult for me to try to play anything like football or any of that. So it's kind of a almost way to fit in, just to say, you know, I play a sport.
Matt was 3 years old, I think about 3 and a half, and we just started noticing at home times that he might reach for something and be a little off. Dan and I decided to take him to an ophthalmologist to have a good thorough vision check, and the doctor showing us the first MRIs, and there was this huge tumor.
I think like many dads, we all wanted to fix it. Learning that we can't fix it, that we have to entrust the child's care to the doctors, it's difficult. I think at Duke Children's we've found that the decisions are much easier because they seem to have a plan for how to go forward.
We were against using radiation on a very vital part of his brain, and willing to treat him with other options and allow him to grow without the side effects of radiation.
Matt went through about 9 hours of neurosurgery. They came out every hour and told us they were still working under a microscope, removing minute pieces of this tumor. And 3 days later, he was ready to go home. He's an amazing kid.
Again, only 5 or 6 feet. If I go ahead and drop that ball, hear the hole?
Yeah. When we first learned that Matt was blind, of course, that was a stun. The first thing I thought of when Matt suggested that he wanted to play golf was, you can't see the ball, and I can't hit it, and I can.
Hear that sound? Good. Good putt. There we go. Matt's vision is not there, so I have to key on his other senses as far as feel and sound audibly.
Right here. Swing it right through me. Right. Okay. The other way.
Almost everything about the game of golf for him is the same as it is for a sighted person. With the exception of the coach who puts the club head behind the ball, you've got to be as good a golfer as someone who's sighted. So I think it gives him a normalcy that he hadn't had with anything else in his life.
Yep. All right. They always keep moving on me. Currently, I've been off chemo for over 4 years. Brain tumor is still there, causing the blindness. At this point, it has stayed relatively consistent. We're just watching it. It's just watching and waiting. If something does happen, we've got treatment options. So we just keep hoping that we can go a little bit longer.
Listen for it.
Duke Children's is a place, you know, it's hope, reassurance. It can be hard to find in a place where people are dealing with, you know, very hard times in a lot of cases.
The money that people donate through Children's Miracle Network goes directly to the hospitals that are within their network that they're working with. If you give a dollar in this area, that dollar is going to go to Duke Children's.
You know, we're very proud of him. He's making the best out of what he has to go with.
This kid can do so many things better than us because he can't see. He's an incredible judge of character, and Matt sees so much more than we do in so many instances that we're the blind ones so often in comparison to what he shares that he sees.